not very fancy to look at. This is all naturally generated spawn. They had all fallen down into the floor when I added the water. I can add lava or water, obviously. This is not symmetrical. I got tired and I lost control of the pattern, but it's good enough for a prototype so you can see. This is the inside, obviously, of a water jug. All made by hand, so yes, it's not symmetrical. It took me about 5 or 6 hours to build this. I wanted to do a proof of concept to make sure that mobs actually would spawn. Ender people spawn in here too. There's enough 2x2 areas that spiders spawn as well. The loot chest is way up there. You're on your own to figure out how to get to it. This is a pot obviously laying on its side. I would also like to make them vertical as well. It depends on the challenge and what paper is supposed to do. Inside the loot chest will be a few rewards, but mostly it will be a piece of a map. I don't remember the program you make it with. I think it's Pixlr, I'm not sure, where you can take real photographs and paintings and whatnot, images off the internet, translate them into maps and put pieces of them in the chest. I'm not sure what the finished image would look like, and there may be several images. There will also be a CPM piece, a piece of the giant pot at spawn that they have to repair. I don't know how to do that. I'd like to be able to name them or something in such a way that when the right pieces are put in place, not something you just found on the side of the road or something, but the proper pieces are put in the proper places, that it triggers something. I'm
not sure.
So there will be loot, there will be the piece of the map, and there will be a little item, a named item, that has something to do with the history of the place that we're learning about in each of these sections, that you can put in a chest with a dropper thing, and it will register something that you actually did pay attention and learn. That little piece of stuff. So this is not anything like anything traditional. I got tired and it should be about, the base of it should be about twice as long. It was the beginning of a Navajo water jug. But after 5-6 hours I gave up. It also doesn't have a base on it, but I'm pretty sure you guys can figure out what a base looks like. So basically, Adrian, what I'm asking for, Adrian, I don't really know your name, is a cylinder that can either be vertical, horizontal, so and it could even be built in this direction, so X, Y, and Z. So I can take the cylinder, and where I need to, I can push it in, and where I need to, I can pull it out. What I see is you have something where you can make a flat wall, so I could make the flat wall as tall as I need it to be and put my designs onto it and then curl it up into a cylinder and then push in where I want to and pull out where I want to. Please be mindful of the fact in this case the pattern on the pot is just proof of concept kind of thing. It doesn't represent anything. But I need to be cautious and conscientious in how I put patterns and images on the pottery and baskets because they have significance. Even something that seems innocuous and like it wouldn't have any particular meaning at all can be very meaningful. And like I said, I don't want to be disrespectful or insulting to people who have been harmed enough by good intentions. You know what I mean? I want these to be spawn generators. Oh, I should also tell you that my gamma is set to 1000, which is why it's not even really casting much of a shadow. But, so even at nighttime, everything looks like it's daylight. It's just easier for me to see underground and stuff when I'm playing other things, you know, like BBD and whatnot. It also, oh, I dropped my mouse. It also makes for better recording, so I don't have to worry about all that junk. The purpose of the pottery is, and baskets, there will be baskets as well. Baskets will be constructed, of course, out of hay bales, but also out of pretty much every kind of log and plank in the game. I would like to have the option for that, as well as probably some wool. Sorry, I had to pause recording. There was no way I could pretend that I could look for my mouse and talk to the recording at the same time. So baskets will be made out of wooden things, including slabs, stairs, and probably fences. So I can do lattice work and so on. Pretty much any organics. I'm not sure if I'll use leaf blocks. It's possible. So if you need to know what materials I need to make items out of, I better start thinking of a pretty comprehensive list, because it'll be darn near everything in the game. The pottery, as you can see, surprise, it's got redstone in it, and it's got this stuff, which is, what is this? Polished diorite. I did this one just so I could see it well. I wanted a really sharp contrast between light and dark as I was trying to build this thing to try to keep it from going too asymmetrical and crazy. I'm sorry I put the purple lip on it. That doesn't look anything like what I want. So it would be stained clays. It would be probably the ite stones, and maybe in raw version as well as polished. Obsidian. Iron. Iron would represent silver. Redstone would probably represent coral. And I don't know how to represent turquoise. Diamond block is the best thing. But, you know, having diamond blocks running loose on the game, I don't know. Yeah, see, it really looks like, even in this silly texture pack of mine, diamond really does look like turquoise. If anybody has any better suggestions, let me know. So the quests will be to find these pots, battle your way into them, and get the loot, and then find your way back. In some of the ones that are going to be farther away in the map, there will be probably teleporters, but I want a few of them that are just sort of over the hill where you can't see them right away, that you get to on foot or by horseback. There's plenty of horses on the map. So this is my basic concept, a cylinder that can be pulled and pushed into shape. I'm telling you from about this part of the neck to about here is about how big this pot should be. Because it's a water pot. Cylinders that I can pull and push, that I can make walls, put the designs on the walls, and then start stretching and shaping them in various different shapes. I like to use fairly traditional shapes, but, you know, like any art form, Native American art has changed with time and continues to change with time. So there's a lot of contemporary shapes and so on that weren't used 1,000 years ago or even 100 years ago. So a little bit of modern and it's just like any art form, it doesn't stay static. Let's see. So I think that's about it. Oh yeah, I forgot to say that yes, the pots are lined. Because the ones that, there will be a huge vertical one at spawn. It's going to have a crack in it, and yes, I want the orange water particles to be visible, leaking out. The thing still holds water, it's still a container. It's still useful, but it's fragile and in danger of breaking permanently, and the player gets to restore it, which is sort of a theme in Native America anyway, that it's badly damaged and in danger of being ruined and or useless, and people are working very, very hard to restore it. Maybe it won't be like it used to be, but it'll be something great. So there it is! Your challenge, should you decide to accept it, is to design filters that can do this. You don't necessarily have to line it. I would like it to be 2 blocks. Give it like 2 blocks. touch the arms, don't bend. Bye! All inclusive. Yeah. Well, we're getting there.
I will kill you.
Like, share, comment, subscribe, and